approach. So go ahead and give that a try. Which means we need to probably be a reminder of how that goes. How do we use the substitution method?
Six.
X equals 0.6 for what? That's right, in the other equation, right? So 5x minus 5y, which y is the same as x plus 0.6, equals negative 3. I rewrote this equation entirely, except for instead of y, we wrote x plus 0.6. So we'll distribute the negative 5. It'll look like 5x minus 5x. And look at that. That's probably telling you something funny is going to happen. Negative. So 5x minus 5x. Negative 5 times 0.6 is negative 3. And this idea of negative 3. So 5x minus 5x is what?
0.
So we just wind up with negative 3 equals negative 3. That's not how these equations usually work. They leave behind an x, we solve for x, and in the end we find x is equal to some number. But here the x's got completely erased. What we were left with was this true equation. A true equation. Okay, so I'll give you the long story short first. If you wind up getting the variables canceled out in these systems of equations and wind up with a true equation, something true, right? Something that's not true would be like negative 3 equals 5. Negative 3 does not equal 5. But negative 3 does equal negative 3. And since that's true, we can say that this has infinite solutions. Right? Like that's what I would see on your answer line is the words infinite solutions. If it were to come out false, we would say no solutions. There would be no solution possible. Okay. So here's why the solutions are infinite. Because look back at this equation. No matter what I plug in for x, whether I plug a 3 there and a 3 there, I'll get 15 minus 15. Or a 7 there and a 7 there, meaning I'd get 35 minus 35. Or a negative 2 there and a negative 2 there, which means I'd get negative 10 plus 10, and still get 0. Like all those things would get canceled out. No matter what I plug in for x, this part gets canceled out, and I'm left with negative 3 equals negative 3, which is true. So if you think about it, this way, like I can't mess it up. I can't mess up this equation by plugging in the wrong thing for x. I can plug absolutely anything for x that I want. That makes sense? It will always work. It will always be a true equation. Now, since that happened, any x will work, and that tells me that these equations are the same, because what I did was replace this y with this y, and since everything got canceled out, it must mean that these two equations are identical to each other. And if they're identical, all the solutions for one are the same as the solutions for the other, because they're the same equation. Let me prove it to you that they're the same equation. I'll subtract x from both sides. Y minus x equals 0.6. And let's see, let me write it in reverse order. Negative x plus y equals 0.6. If I multiply both sides of this equation by negative 5, negative 5 times negative x is 5x, negative 5 times y is negative 5y, and negative 5 times positive 0.6 is negative 3, that's exactly the same as the first equation. I just turned the second equation into an identical copy of the first equation. So again, infinite solutions. Two identical equations are going to have the exact same solutions, and they're going to have infinitely many of those. So whether we use elimination and we get all the variables canceling out and we get a true statement, or we use substitution and we get everything canceling out and we get a true statement, in both cases we have infinite solutions. If it comes out false, like 0 equals 2, then we would say no solution. In fact, number 21, that's what's going to happen here. Negative 18x plus plus 6y equals 24. 3x minus y equals negative 2. Alright, I see this negative 18x, I see this positive 3x, and it seems like real simple. If I were to multiply this by 6, I would get a positive 18x because it cancels. So I'll multiply by 6. So my first equation looks the same, negative 18x plus 6y equals 24. My second equation, 6 times 3x is 18x, just like I want. 6 times negative y is negative 6y. And then I see these are going to cancel out. 6 times negative 2 is negative 12. Well, negative 18x plus 18x is 0. 6y minus 6y is 0. 0 equals 24 plus negative 12 is 12. So what do you notice is different about this equation as opposed to this equation? Not true. So this equation here with all the variables getting canceled out is false. Right? So there's just no x and y that's going to work. It's impossible. So we have no solution. Right? So if we didn't get into the full details and the depth of it, we could just say that if we get a false statement, false equation here, we have no solution. If we get a true equation here, where all the variables are canceled out, we have infinite solutions.
So when you're doing, like, when you got your 6, pretty much all you're doing is dividing negative 18 method.
Like how I came up with this 6?
Yeah.
Essentially, yeah.
True.
Now that's not really going to work. I'm not always going to be able to just multiply this guy by something and get this number.
Okay.
Right? Because, so this is number 17 from that same section. It's not from the homework, but it makes my point here. Negative 5. When I try and get these to cancel each other out, it just doesn't work. I can't multiply 3 by something to get 4. Likewise, I can't multiply 4 by something to get 3. I can't multiply negative 2 by something to get 5. I can't multiply 5 by something to get negative 2. Unless I'm multiplying by decimals, that's something I can do. But let's, why do that? Let's just keep it simple. Here, I'm looking at these y's. The reason my attention goes to the y's is because I have a positive here and a negative here. And, that's what I want. I want a positive and negative to add together and cancel each other out. So if I were to multiply the top equation by a 5, put the 5 there, and multiply this bottom equation by a 2, then both of these would be a 10. It's a positive 10 and it's a negative 10. Right? So I'm trying to get them to be opposite. I can multiply them both by separate things. That works fine. So multiply both sides by 5, you get 15x. Minus 10y equals negative 25. Now multiply this guy by 2. 2 times 4x is 8x. 2 times 5y is 10y. And 2 times 47 is 94. Adding these together, you get 23x plus 0y equals 23 gives 3. X is 3. Now that I know X is 3, I can find Y. Let's plug it in here. 4 times 3 plus 5Y equals 47. 47. This is 12, so we'll subtract 12 from both sides instead of writing that next step. 47 minus 12 is 30. 5 divided by 5y equals 7. So, again, the reason for all that is to remind you that sometimes you have to multiply both equations by some different number to get either the x's or the y's to cancel each other out when we have the solutions to a system. So everything is going to cancel out, and the result has to make no sense. Zero does not equal 12. It doesn't make any sense, so there's no solution. But for that special case of something equals the thing that it is equal to, negative 3 does equal negative 3. It's true, so we have infinite solutions. And if I were to have done it this way and try to use elimination, instead of getting negative 3 equals negative 3, I'd get 0 equals 0. Also would tell me there aren't infinite solutions because 0 does equal 0. But we only got negative 3 equals negative 3 because I used substitution as opposed to elimination. But either way, true equation, true statement that's always true is an indication you have infinite solutions. Other questions? Then I'm not like some parents do that, but I do it an obvious way. Like I tell the two girls that they're my favorites, so I don't tell the other one, and then I just yell across the room to Declan, he's right here, and I say that he's my favorite, and they both hear me and say, just said that you're my favorite. So I'm not fully doing that approach. What, your parents do that to you?
Well, we can just tell. Bryce's favorite.
Okay. Well.
Taller than the youngest kid at lunch. The oldest.
I thought you were the youngest.
I am the youngest.
So why aren't you the favorite?
Because I'm just not.
Well, it's the newer.
I'm the oldest male in my house, and I really think I'm the favorite.
No, I'm more of a kid that did everything.